Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can implement these three patterns with the help of C programming. So before starting, if you go to detail or description of this video, so you will find various links related to playlist. So you can watch them to know programming in better way. So these playlists are having various kind of videos, so do watch them. Now, I'm going to explain this pattern first, then I will be converting it into this and then this. So here you can see all these three patterns are right angled pattern. So if I identify the logic for this pattern, so first I need to implement a loop so that I can count on which row number I am currently available, or you can say how many rows I need to print this pattern. So right now, for example, I am taking, like, we need to print only 5 rows, right? So I am implementing first loop that will begin from 1 and it will repeat 5 times. So this is initialization, I is starting from 1. This is condition, termination condition, I less than equals to 5, and it is increment part. So this loop will repeat 5 times. Now, if you see carefully, so here we need to put some spaces. Here we need to put some spaces. So in first row, 4 spaces are required. In second row, 3, then 2, then 1, and then 0. So before printing these digits, we need to print the spaces and then we can print the digits properly. So if you identify the logic, so here total 5 rows are printed, and at the top row you can see number of spaces are 4. So if I create a logic, so it is 5 minus 1, so it will be 4. Then if I write 5 minus 2, then second row spaces will be available. Then 5 minus 3, 5 minus 4, and 5 minus 5. So this way you can see these values will be available. So 5, you can see 5 is number of row. So if you are reading number of rows from user, so here you can put n, or here also you can put n, and this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be available through I. So now I need to implement one more loop that will print the spaces, and the condition will be 5 minus I. Termination condition for that loop will be 5 minus I. So now I am going to implement that loop. So it will start from 1 and its termination condition will be this, and J++, and inside this loop I am using a printf statement which will print a space. So inside these double quotes you need to put a blank space, right? Now after completion of this loop I have to print these digits. So for that I am going to print, I am going to implement one more loop. This will repeat I times. And again I am using a printf statement. So it will print value of I. Then I am closing this. After this, I am writing one more printf which will print new line. So this way I implemented the complete logic to print that pattern. So now I am going to explain it line by line so that you can understand how it will be printed. So starting from at top, I is equals to 1. So let's say I is 1. Check the condition. It is true. Then we come to this loop. So it is starting from 1. And here we are checking the condition J less than equals to 5 minus I. So what is the value of I? It is 1. So 5 minus I is 4. So this loop will repeat 4 times and it will print 4 spaces. And we require 4 spaces. So they will be printed, right? So here I represented space with hyphen or dash. But in real time, if you provide a space in double quotes, single space, so that space will be printed automatically. Then after termination of this loop, control will transfer to this. So it is starting from 1, k less than equals to I. So here you can see I is 1. So this loop will repeat one time, and it is also printing value of I. So I is 1. So one time 1 will be printed. Then after completion of this loop, this printer will print new line. So cursor will come to new line. Now we have to move here I plus plus. So this time you can see value of I is 2. Then check this condition, it is true. Then we come to this loop. So I j is starting from 1, and here condition is 5 minus I. So this time value of I is 2. So 5 minus 2 will be 3. So it means this loop will repeat 3 times now, and 3 spaces will be printed. And here you can see we require only 3 spaces, right? So this way, this loop is efficient for printing the spaces, and this condition is working properly. After completion of this loop, we come to this loop. Here k is starting from 1, and if you check the condition, k less than equals to I. So this time I is 2. So this loop will repeat 2 times, and 2 times it will be printing value of I. So right now I is 2. So it will print 2 times. Right? So this way, I hope you understood this loop we are using to print spaces, and this loop we are using to print digits. And the first loop is controlling how many times we need to repeat the whole process. Right? And if you are reading how many numbers, number of lines we need to print, so you can read that inside this n variable. And wherever you are using 5, you can replace that with n. So I hope you understood this logic, how it is printing. Now we need to convert it into this logic. So if you want to convert it into this, so instead of printing I, you can simply print j here. You can simply print j here. Sorry, you can simply print k, not j. You can simply print k. Why so? So this loop will be same, it will be printing spaces here also, like same way. But if we come here and let's say I is 2. So if I is 2, so at that time this loop will repeat 2 times, starting from 1, and it will go to 2. So first it will print 1, that is required at second row, and then it will be incremented, so its value will be 2, and second time it will print 2. So instead of printing I, that were printing same value, same row, we need to print a value starting from 1 to the digits that is equivalent to that row number. So if we are on second row, we need to print 1, 2. If we are on third row, we need to print 1, 2, and 3. So starting from 1 till the particular row number. So that you can do with the help of this thing, right? Rest of the things will be same. Now if we move to here, so again space logic will be same. We just need to print the digits in continuous order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So here we need a new variable. Here we need a new variable. So I'm removing this, and here let's say ijk, I'm using one variable l, and its initial value is 1. Its initial value is 1, and here I am using L. So L will be printed, and after just printf, I am going to increase its value by 1. I am going to increase its value by 1. So if I is 1, then this loop will print spaces 4 times. Then we come to here, it will repeat 1 time only. So L will be printed, L is 1, so it will be printed, then L will be incremented. So initially L is 1, but now it will become 2. So this is the single rotation where we are printing value of L, and simultaneously we are increasing it by 1 also. Then I will be 2. In next rotation, I will become 2. Then this loop will repeat 5 minus 2 3 times. Then it will print 3 spaces for second row. Then we come here, this time it will repeat 2 times because value of I is 2. And C, last value of L is 2. So first it will print 2, then it will be incremented to 3. So when we are printing value of L as 2 and we are incrementing it for 3. So this is a single rotation. These two steps are performing one rotation right now. So one more rotation is available. So L will be printed as 3 because its value is 3 and then it will be incremented to 4. So printing of L and incrementing its value by 1 together, they are a single step. So if this loop is repeating 2 times, so printf will work 2 times and increment will work 2 times. So that correct values will be printed. So it is completed the new line, then I will be incremented to 3. So when we will be reaching to this loop, so L will be starting from 4. And here you can see we require 4. So this way you can print these patterns. So this space loop is important. And after completion of this loop, you can implement the loop which will print the digits accordingly. So in all three cases, you saw first and second loops are same. We didn't change anything in these two loops. We just changed the third loop so that we can implement variety of logic. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel, go to playlist, and there you can watch various videos related to programming. I have uploaded more than 1000 videos on my channel. So do watch them, and thank you for watching this video.